Personally, I like the Raspberry Pi 02W. I think it's a great SBC that has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, which I use mostly, but consumes minimal power. Of course, I cannot use it for heavy load applications due to insufficient RAM and clock speed, but I still like to use it for my projects if possible. Also this time, I'd like to use a battery. So it can be a Raspberry Pi 02W server that operates by connecting two 18650 batteries. In one of my projects, I introduced an MQTT broker that runs on AWS IoT core. I believe you already know my projects. At this time, I send the image frame buffer obtained from ESP32CAM to a specific topic, and I was able to check this image data in the client application made with Flutter. Because this system is based on AWS IoT, it has a static IP. So if you have the server's IP and credentials, you can connect from anywhere in the world and receive data on a specific topic. That's great, right? For more details on this project, please see the video description below. Sometimes we need an MQTT broker running locally for testing purposes or just to try it out. Let me show you how to try this easily. Currently, my Raspberry Pi is operating on battery and simply allows a Wi-Fi connection. How to install Mosquitto MQTT Broker is very detailed if you Google it. Simply install Mosquitto via APT and your server is ready. We also install Mosquitto clients for testing purposes. During this installation process, the package manager will automatically configure the Mosquitto server to start on boot. Let's check the status of the Mosquitto service. You should see the text active running if the service has started up properly. The Mosquitto server is ready. Now let's create two clients. This client will subscribe to a specific topic. Then the MQTT broker will deliver messaging on a specific topic. This subscribe to the topic MQTT/new topic. Let me create a new client. This client can be a publisher. This time, I will send a message to the specific topic. You can see the message being printed from the MQTT client above. An MQTT broker is the main component of MQTT protocol. It receives MQTT messages from all MQTT clients and forwards them to all clients who subscribe to those topics. What we will do this time is to modify the Mosquitto service so that it can be accessed from other devices. Let's add two things to enable remote access without authentication. Specify the service port number 1883. It also allows the anonymous so that anyone can access it. This should not be allowed if you plan to use a static IP. Okay, we need to restart service. Now you can access it from other devices. I'm subscribing to a specific topic for testing. Messages received from other clients will be displayed here. Here is my iPhone screen. Download the MQTT client from the App Store. There are many MQTT clients apps, so you can use the app you want. Add a new MQTT broker, enter the local IP address of your Raspberry Pi. The default port num 1883 for the MQTT broker is set. Also the version is V3. Here we can set the topic. My topic is the same as before. All done. Tap the save button. Now it has a connection with the MQTT broker and is waiting for messages on the topic I have specified. You can click the send icon above to send a message to this topic. If you look at the console behind the iPhone screen, you can see message from iPhone printed. A message was published from the iPhone to the MQTT broker and the subscriber read it. Let's create another client to get messages on the iPhone this time. The third client sent a message to a specific topic. I confirmed that this message was also received by the first client and the second client. Today we checked about MQTT Broker running on Raspberry Pi and how to test it. This can be useful for many projects, so give it a try. Alright, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.